The most important thing for any bride to remember is ultimately the bride is the one that's wearing the dress, so she really needs to buy the dress that speaks to her.
Camille's first appointment of the day is with an Indian American bride seeking the middle path between the traditional and the modern.
Welcome
nice to meet
Plenso.
You.
My name is Rashi Dada, and I'm here because I want to find a gown for my reception. I'm nervous because our film is so big on culture and traditions, and I have a lot of people to please. Today, I brought my mom, my sister-in-law, and my two cousins.
So, have you done any wedding gown shopping?
I've looked around a lot. Actually tried on, no. Because what I'm looking for is something like really different. I'm having a traditional Indian wedding, and during the ceremony part, I will be wearing a red, what we call a lehenga. So that's like a traditional Indian dress. And for the reception, it's important that I not wear an Indian dress only because I've been to tons and tons of weddings. You know, nothing really sticks out no matter how great it is. So I just wanted something out of the norm.
No other female in our family has ever worn a non-traditional outfit to her wedding.
I want something either like a salmon color.
Okay.
A salmon rusty color I like. White. In the Indian culture, you wear at funerals.
Not a lot of our designers will make gowns in the colors that she's looking for, so a challenge.
With a lot of...
A lot of embellishment.
A lot,
A
yeah.
lot of pow. Diamonds and bling everywhere, everywhere.
The girls that I come with are all very opinionated.
In an Indian wedding, nothing is about you. There's so many family members, traditions we have to follow.
I have to kind of please everyone, otherwise they're gonna kill me. I don't think I would ever be able to buy a dress that I loved and that my family does not love.
And is there a budget to be respectful of?
About $4,000.
Okay, so you ready to have some fun?
I'm ready.
So, tell me a little bit about fiance. What's his name?
His name is Dave Chopra. We met about 3 years ago through a mutual friend. And the first day we ever spoke on the phone, we were on the phone for like 4.5 hours. My parents are pretty happy that it is someone Indian just because our family is so big on culture and traditions. And I just can't wait to get married to him. I'm excited.
Let me go to work.
Thank you.
A beaded dress with a lot of bling and in color. Being that we're in a bridal salon, and 99.9% of the dresses are white or ivory, that's a tall order. Got some dresses here.
Oh, I'm excited. Oh my God, I love it already.
You love it?
Yeah. Oh my God, I'm nervous. I hope they like it. I think they will. It's so nice. How can you not? What do you guys think?
The bottom is like you're about to do like salsa in a nightclub. Like,
you don't love it?
I don't like the bottom.
It is a little like, yeah, the bottom's like, it's can-can.
The bottom was so tacky. I can't even imagine that dress in a peach or apricot.
I feel like you need maracas in your hand and bananas on your head.
They're so critical. It's a little annoying because like I wanted them to love it as much as I love it.
I think you should get something like a little more fitting and then flare out.
This is what you should have. You should have more bling at the bottom, less in the top because you're gonna be wearing a lot of jewelry here.
So we could bling up the bottom
something.
Of the dress.
So you pop. Like, you know our outfits are 30,
but
40
this
pounds.
Does. Look at this.
But
this
you have to remember, we're working here on a budget. And the more bling, the more ka-ching. Rashi's gonna need to do everything in her power to get her family on board with her vision. If not, no sale. Okay, back to the drawing board.
Rashi is eager to make a break with Indian tradition by wearing a Western-style gown to her reception.
We're having a traditional Indian wedding. We're not allowed to wear white.
But the odds are not in her favor.
Not a lot of our designers will make gowns in the colors that she's looking for, so a challenge.
And her opinionated family are making it even harder.
I don't like the bottom.
It is a little like, yeah, the bottom's like, it's can-can.
So Camille pulls the most vibrantly colored dress in the store, hoping to please Rashi and her entourage.
Uh-oh. We love it.
That's the color of our weddings. Red is the color of our weddings.
What do you think of this dress if it had bling, major bling?
I mean, this reminds me of like the opera singers. I mean, it's a nice dress, just, you know, not really what I had in mind.
Okay.
I really, really, really wanted Rashi to come out in that red dress.
It's gonna be hard. I hope they can find something that'll be pleasing to everyone.
But Camille is struggling to find a dress that can be made in the salmon color Rashi wants with the heavy beading favored by her family.
I try to make them understand that of all the, you know, we have almost 100 designers here. There's a handful that will make us a dress in color. Of that handful, half of those will do something that's totally beaded like she wants. Is this a challenge? You bet. I have one more dress in mind and I'm hoping that it's the one. Okay.
Looks like an Indian lehenga. Usually an Indian thing is two-piece, and it looks like it's like at the top and the skirt. I feel like my family's gonna like it.
Rashi's requirements for a dress are a challenge for Camille.
We're not allowed to wear white.
Dress one was a perfect match, until her family shot it down.
I don't like the bottom.
Yeah, the bottom's like, it's can-can.
Now in dress two, Camille and Rashi have high hopes.
I feel like my family's gonna like it, because it looks like an Indian lehenga. God, I hope they like it. Mom, I know you're gonna like this one. Cause it looks like a lehenga, right?
Yeah.
Didn't you want something that didn't look like a traditional lehenga?
That dress looks exactly like a lehenga. What's the point of getting a gown if it's gonna look exactly like an Indian lehenga?
I don't get the point of a dress then. It looks like an Indian outfit.
She's saying, what's the point of wearing it? The point is that it's a gown and it's not a lehenga.
Mom, what's the matter?
I don't know, something not going right with.
And then on the sides where it's like plain, you could put more stones.
Yeah, but it looks like exactly the lehenga then.
Rashi's family is really not cutting this girl any slack. It's not that they can't find a dress that Rashi loves. They don't want her in a gown at all.
Rashi's family said no to the dress she loved. And even in a gown resembling a traditional Indian outfit, her family still finds something to criticize.
Didn't you want something that didn't look like a traditional lehenga? And doesn't this kind of defeat the purpose?
But it's not an Indian lehenga, it's a dress.
I'm not getting, do we want tradition or not? Now this looks like a traditional Indian dress. Well, I thought that's what they wanted.
Can you guys give me one compliment at least?
Do you really, really, honestly, like, love this and this is the one, though?
I don't mind this one. I think it looks nice.
Yeah, but I don't want you to say I don't mind it. I want you to say I love it.
I like the other one much better.
The first one?
Mm-hmm. You were the only one that liked that one.
I actually really, really like that dress.
You loved it in
I loved
room.
It.
Not for her.
Not for our custom. Dad won't like it.
My family hates my dress, and I absolutely love it. I will not get it.
The bottom line here is Rashi, she doesn't want to be cookie cutter. And then that just, her family's just not going to let that happen.
Unable to convince her family to follow her lead, Rashi leaves the dress she loves behind.